months of gestation, now it is 34 weeks. Now baby is off respiratory support. As you see, you can see now, baby is showing the suprasternal recession and the substernal recession, and also baby developed stridor. Okay. Baby developed stridor, and just want to see that is there any evidence of laryngomalacia. This is the frequency of probe I used, C8 and 5. I transfer the place here just to look at the airway. Hey, good morning, dear. You can hear the sound also. I just want to see how the RF epiglottic pores. This is the airway, transversely placed, and I want to see the, just sweep from anterior most to the, you can see that? Yeah. I'll just zoom it for you, and you can see the vocal cords, how they are variable and shorted. You can see the omega shaped epiglottis, you see how, just to see that is any abduction problem, and that is the array epiglottic fold. So you're done. Ultrasound airway demonstrates evidence of laryngomalacia. And you can also see just hyperextending the neck. Hyperextension of the neck most of the times dissolves the stridor, and also you can see the suprasternal recession is reduced. So this is very important, one of the manoeuvres we see, especially when there is supraglottic type of stridor. So inspiratory stridor, just extend the neck, resolves the suprasternal recession, substernal recession, even the stridor, and you can see the saturation also is pretty good in this position. So always better tell the nurse that baby should be nursed a little bit hyperextended neck. That will resolve most of the problems and even the intervention also. Thank you.
The clinical and the ultrasound examination demonstrated laryngomalacia and was confirmed by the ENT surgeon after evaluating the upper airway using the bronchoscopy. Thank you so much.